Hi everyone, here is your friend Wester Desamou from Basla Production Academy here in Berlin, Germany. And today I would like to present you one of my favorite bass guitar, which is a Splendour jazz bass guitar from Cunningham Bass and Guitars out of Australia. As a musician and producer, I think I am in the best place to explain what a professional bass guitar is. I've been playing bass for a long time, but having experience playing a professional bass is more than playing bass for a long time. And you need to have the right bass player or the right person who knows bass, who know what a bass guitar is, and also not just playing the instrument, but have knowledge in the production field to explain to you what a professional bass guitar is. Splendour is, as you can see, and I'm going to give you some insight of the bass. Cunningham is one of the company that you can trust in buying bass, because what I'm going to show you is the body of the bass, how they make it, and you have the pickups, which is very high professional pickups, and I'm going to explain why you need to have a bass with a professional pickups, and you have good preamp, professional preamp also, and the body of the bass, which is very important when you are playing a bass with made with good wood. What does it mean? And as you can see, the bass is here, and the body, you can see a hole here, which give the bass a kind of sounds of acoustic, which is really nice when you do a professional recording. And I think most of the producers are looking for bass like that. And you have the frets that are really well calculated and well made. All these things are very important. Not just the front, but you have the back of the bass that is also well made. You can see it's a very strong bass, okay? And here's the signature. Here you can see, let me see if I can make a zoom out of it for you. I mean, of course, the light is not really good here to show you everything. But what I really like about the way he constructed the bass is that you can move the electronic parts very easily. I'm sorry for the noise. But here you can see all the inside. This is something that he used, a kind of, you don't have any screws, I will say. It's a kind of magnetic thing that they are using to make the cover, and don't be afraid, it's not going to lose. It will not get out easily, as you could see that I was making some power to get it out. So it's really well made. And then you can close it again. So, and then since it's closed, you see it's really well made. I'm sorry again for the light, but I think you will understand that since I'm making the video on my own. I am not in a recording or professional video studio for that. I'm doing all here on my own, so I hope you will understand that. So now let me play you some reggae. All what I'm going to play for you now are pure or flat sound. I'm just using my preamp to send the signal into my DAW so that you can hear it. But it's not mix or any effect or plugins or nothing. It's a pure sound so that you can figure out the real sounds of the bass, okay? I hope you could hear it at the beginning of the video where I was playing different parts. Like I play regular playing, like finger playing, and I also play some harmonics to let you hear how the harmonics of the bass sounds. And I was able to play also some tapping, because you need to be able to understand all these parts when you are in a production field, because all these things will be matters, okay? So don't think because you can play just jazz bass or standard on a bass mean that the bass is good. You need to try to different type of playing with the bass to really know or figure out if the bass is a good bass. So I was able also to play some slap, because you need to figure out if it sounds good when you're slapping it. So I was doing all these things. And now what I'm going to explain is this preamp here. Here you have the main volume button. And here you have the tone to control it. And here is where the bass is activated. I mean, where the preamp is activated. So you have the mid, where you can control the mid based on what tone you want. And here you have the high, if you want the high sounds. I will play it and let you hear it. Here you have a mid frequency, where you can control either the mid and the high here. And you have two of these here. You can control the mid frequencies. It's a really complicated bass. I need to be honest with you. But here you have it on passive. If you switch it up and then you activate it. And then if you bring it down there, so you have also more power, I will say, in the bass. Most of the time, I just leave it in the middle, and then that's all. But if you want also to play without the preamp activated with all this EQ, you can also pull that up. When you pull it up like that, then the preamp or the low, mid, high frequencies, they are not activating anymore. So like now you have only the main or a flat sounds with the preamp, and also the tone. Also you can do the same. So now when you push them down like that, so now the bass is activated and all these buttons like low, mid frequencies and high, they are all activated. One of the things that you really need to understand again from the a professional bass guitar is the level of the pickups. And I will explain that since I have knowledge in music production. Most of the time, the reason why you don't find a good result with a cheap bass guitar is that you don't have a professional pickups, also a professional preamp. What these two things mean in a production, how you can get a good sound. Let's say, for example, if I play a note here on the G string, and then I play a note on the low B strings, there will be a difference between these two notes because I may have more power or touch the string with more power when I play the G string and I play the low B softer. But the thing is that when you do a recording and you need to have a certain response on the sounds. So if the sounds is good in the higher note and it's poor on the lower note, so the recording will not be good, because when you get into the mixing process, when you process the track, you will see that the sounds give you not enough power to mix the track. So it's really important when you buy a bass to pay attention on how good the pickups are, so that they can, it's like a microphone. If you are recording a vocal with a cheap microphone and also you record the same vocal with an expensive microphone, so the expensive microphone will give you a better result in the final process of mixing this vocal track. And it is the same thing. So like when you have a good bass guitar, you have good a microphone to pick the sounds, like this one, you have a better sounds when you do a recording. But if you have a cheap bass, this is the reason why you can go to a store, you find a bass for $100, and then next to the bass for $100, you find another one for $12,000, $3,000, and $6,000. So there is a difference. Why do they make a difference in prices? Because materials that they are using to build the bass are not the same. And more a bass is expensive, that means more they put more good materials in it. And if you are from the Caribbean like me, so that will be a good bass for you. Either you want to play compa or you want to play zouk, calypso, all this type of music. This is the bass that will give you all what you want. Since you can hear this bass, so it gives you a kind of acoustic sounds, which I really like. And if you are a jazz a bass player, whatever style or genre of music that you are playing, this bass will be good for you. It's not just a bass for jazz musician, okay? It's an all-in-one bass. So it sounds really professional, I will say highly professional. I think Cunningham was very mad with me because they asked me to make a video with the bass for them. But I told him that I cannot make a video with the bass if I don't try it, because I need to make a proof of it so that I tell my friend about it. So now, since I have it for 4 years, and I experience it, I record a lot of track with this bass. So now I think I'm in a better position to tell you, yes, now you can go ahead and buy bass from him, because the bass is really well made. And if you buy bass from Cunningham, you will not be deceived, because you will have something good to either play live or in the studio. which is what all producers or good musicians are looking for. If you would like to buy bass from them, you can go on their Facebook page or on their Instagram page, has Cunningham Bass and Guitars. They base, like I said, in Australia. And what I like about it, when they send you a bass, if you order from them, the bass come well packed, and you can ask them to put it in a hot case. Anywhere you are, you can order bass from them and they will ship it to you. If you want to play zouk music, which is another style of music in the Caribbean, if you want more information about the bass, I can give you information. You can email me in basslaproduction.academy@gmail.com. If you are a producer that you want a really good bass sound, you can contact me in that email, or an artist that are looking for a good bass recording. So you can also contact me and I will use my Splendor jazz bass to record you a great sounding bass guitar for your track. And also contact Cunningham either on Facebook or Instagram so that you have more information if you want a bass. So as you can see, he also write my name here on the bass. Let's see if I can make it clear for you. That is my signature, and you can also ask them to put your signature wherever you want and they will do it for you. Thanks for your time and hope to see you with a beautiful Splendor bass soon. Bye.